Grand rising, everybody. So today's topic is going to be the conversation featuring Hazel E. and Masika Part 1. Reality stars Hazel E. and Masika have had a long-standing feud going back years. Claims from both sides include issues such as trafficking, plastic surgery, and child endangerment have been tossed back and forth, armed with different agendas and opinions. The ladies finally decide to sit face to face and attempt to settle their differences. But can they? So you know how Zeus does it. They get both sides. Hazel's was, she had put, chose the cast for, 11 Hip Hop Hollywood. And, she basically said they wanted to cast, HOE. I could have picked and had her be my friend, so I chose her. What made me mad was when she started messing with the young bird, knowing I was messing with him, which I don't know if it's just me, but it's girl code. If you've had relations with a man, even if you guys are mutual, y'all don't mess with each, go up behind each other. That's so disgusting. So she was like, yeah, me and her, I picked her because, you know, we used to hang out or whatever. I thought legitimately we were friends. Masika Kalisha was just like, oh no, me and her were never friends like that. And I just have an issue of her talking about my child. And I need an apology. We know their feud goes back years, and talking mess about each other or each other's children definitely is not okay, because if you have a problem with me, I feel you could say whatever the heck you want to say, but talking about my offspring will piss me off. I've actually had to remove myself from certain people because I know in my lower self that I would want to cause physical violence, which is not okay. So I just let people at this point say what they want to say. And it's funny when I read comments of trolling on the internet, or people have my personal information and may message me on Skype. It's hilarious. I don't even respond to it. I honestly don't care. But, so that was her, Masika's point of view. So, Hazel E. Oh, before I get into it, Ray J goes and checks on him, tells Hazel she looks beautiful. And then Masika was like, so Ray J, how does it feel to have relations with someone so ugly? Hold on, I'm drinking some tea, y'all. You know, this woman says light-skinned, blonde hair, green eyes, but that bee looked like a damn dog. So, like, if you're coming into a situation, start it off positively. So, Hazel gets there first and sits down. Then, Masika is standing a few feet away. And Hazel's like, well, I know you had a rough week. You were fired. You know, I thought me and you were cool back in the day. And, you know, I casted you on Love & Hip Hop. And I just want to know what our problems are. And you could tell by the energy, because as Hazel's talking, Masika's dead quiet. It's like you could hear your heartbeat. That's how quiet the set was. So, Hazel was just like, excuse me, I'm just talking to myself then. I'm just talking to myself then. So, Masika was like, I have a MFing problem, but you talking about my child, B.I. I'm trying not to cuss. So until you apologize, B.I., I have nothing to effing say to you. So then Hazel's like, well, what did I say about your kid, your child? Masika's like, now I'm finna crack you in the head, H-O-E. You know what the F you said? I should pick up this chair. So then Hazel's like, well, you did have a rough week and your daughter has so much to look forward to. So look up to. So then Masika was like, why the F you talking about my MF and daughter, B.I.? And then she proceeds to throw a champagne glass with champagne or something in there and it shatters. Hazel just kind of puts her hands up. Then that's when Masika's like mad, like, I will beat you up, you fat B, mother to father, you FMB, with your bastard daughter. Remember at this time of shooting, Hazel E's daughter was only 8 weeks old. What a cute girl, too. F-U, da-da-da-da-da, you're a fat B, da-da-da-da-da. How is this communication, ladies and gentlemen? If you have a problem with somebody and your intention is to have a conversation with somebody, why are you going there trying to fight? Like, you destroying property? I know for a fact Zeus doesn't own those homes. A lot of times those nice mansions in LA area, a lot of people rent them out. You're destroying stuff, they get charged. You're that mad? Equally, both ladies have said some pretty messed up stuff. I hold Hazel E and Masika accountable for the things that they've said over the years. It's so crazy, their beef is so long. I literally have to look up a transcript to see all the BS that they said about each other. She's like, you ain't nothing. So then Hazel E's like, dude, so you're gonna do S trafficking, B, you're nothing but a hoe, F you, and da da da. This is when it goes left. Then Masika's like, bring your fat A over here and come run up on me, you fat B. You can't even run because you're so fat. F you, F you, F you. It gets out of control. Masika's carried to her room. The producers or whatever on the show is trying to calm her down. And she's like, y'all security tight because on Love & Hip Hop, it's real easy to get past security. Y'all tight, y'all tight. I'm trying to get that B. I'm trying to get that B. So Hazel E goes in the room and she's talking to one of her friends and her husband. And then she's like, I'm so postpartum. And like, she goes into the restroom and cries. And at this point, her friend, I don't even know her name, was like, how you gonna talk about a baby like that, though? That's terrible. So even before they went to the room, Hazel E was like, you need to worry about your baby daddy with his one eye. He sees every bee but you. He ain't worried about you. Be worried about your baby daddy. So this is when it goes blow for blow. Then she's upset and she's like, I'm postpartum. You know, I just had a baby. You know, your tummy gets stretched, but it's very easy to lose. Babies do not make you fat. It's the food you decide to eat. If we were to stick more to eating more healthier things instead of sugar and things like that, you'd be better. I've done it myself. Clap back real quick after having my first child. Anyways, so at this point, I'm thinking, are these ladies really here to communicate and solve their problems? Because it hurts me to see my people at war with each other, but then we give the other brother a pass, and these people who come to our communities and do some racist things to us, killing us, destroying our property, and people who really have a hate for people that look like me. But y'all don't have that energy for that, but you have the energy to want to fight and be terrible to each other and say hurtful stuff. And I was out of line for Hazel E to say, so what you gonna do, get S traffic? Like, that's not funny, because in real life, the children and adults are being S trafficked. That's nothing funny to laugh at. That sounds ignorant. Like, you gotta realize when someone is irate like that, and they're getting screaming, if you literally talk like this, it forces them to be quiet. It forces them to listen. They can't scream. You get what I'm saying? But I don't know. We fight each other but don't have energy for the people who literally hate us. So she goes to the room, they come back, and from that point, I believe Hazel E did admit to coming from her Masika's motherhood at this point, because there was allegations made that, I'm gonna say allegedly, I ain't trying to get in trouble, that Masika's daughter has swallowed Xanax pills, and that it was so much stuff put down that basically CPS was coming into play. This is why I tell parents, either lock your medications up or put that crap out of sight, out of mind. I'm just saying. So she was just like really angry. And all they did was scream and yell. And as the ladies are in the room, one of the staff members is picking up glass. And I believe they had the medic on site. Like, I think most of the people you all idolize on this damn TV, you idolize them, these people have serious freaking issues. They can't communicate. They just want to act a fool for television. Like, really? Like, literally, I don't think they can do a non-scripted show like this without being told what to do. It's crazy. It's true. They can't do anything without being told what to do. And my thing is, if I have an issue with somebody, if I really care, I would be trying to fix it. But then it goes back to, sometimes you cannot fix it. You have to realize that forgiveness has nothing to do with another person. It has everything to do with yourself and moving on. There are certain people currently that I refuse to be around, because all they bring is bad weather, bad energy, and chaos. And I don't have time for that. I'm working on really trying to be a calmer person. I've really been trying to work on doing better. And I don't have time for that, because there are certain people on this planet Earth that literally all I could see myself doing is going upside their head, and I won't stop like a mad woman. And it's not worth the energy that yelling and that screaming will cause heart attack, stroke, aneurysms, high blood pressure. Who has time for that type of stuff? Not me. So it seems at this point that nothing is being resolved and that there's no common ground. Because Masika, just like Hazel Lee, talks a lot of stuff. You know what I mean? Says things. I mean, look at them. They fight on TV, both of them. They both said colorist things, both of them. Because I know for a fact that Hazel E has said, you nappy-headed HOEs with your and your brown black BIT, you're still an African woman. Just because you're lighter than I or somebody else doesn't make you better. You black bees are jealous of me. See, This whole team light skin and dark skin is very colorist, and colorist to me equals racism. Doesn't matter that one is lighter or one is darker. Does it really matter? No, it's what's on the inside, man. I can't stress this enough. I believe I also, due to these ladies saying some of the mean crap that they've said, I've unfollowed them on like Instagram and Twitter, because I don't got time to sit up here and listen to this type of stuff. Like, you're better because you're light. And I noticed one thing. As I used to follow Masika, I noticed on that episode, she was a lot darker, way darker. But then now that I see her on line like Instagram or Twitter, she looks way lighter. Is she bleaching her skin? Just a question. I'm not accusing, but is she doing that? So it's like, when communicating, both parties have to listen and hear. If she says she better apologize, first of all, if I'm having a conversation with you, I definitely do not like when someone says, "Goddess, you better," because if you tell me I better, I don't care who you are in this world, I'm not going to do it. You're not going to talk to me like that. Who do you think you are to talk to me in that type of way? I wouldn't let my parents talk to me like that. I don't mind someone asking me. And I feel if Hazel E would have said it like this, because you know their beef goes so long, if she would have just said, "Okay, Masika, hey, how are you doing? I know you just that you had a rough week. I'm sorry for the things that I have said about you, and I am sorry for talking about your daughter." Then in response, as someone communicating, Masika would have said, "Okay, thank you, Hazel, for apologizing to me. And I, too, apologize for the things that I've said about you and your family. I am so sorry." Boom. From there, they could have broke down the things that were bothering them. But you can't go into a conversation trying to scream at somebody and things like that. That don't ever work. And that causes somebody to want to snap, even the calmest person, or just like, "Hey, I don't want to talk about this." Like, if Masika and Hazel E were smart, they would try to be making money together, because I love seeing black entrepreneurs. No scamming stuff, because I've seen Masika Kalisha online saying, I'm going to say allegedly, that she's a multimillionaire and that she could teach people how to invest their money or make money allegedly, but she's taking people's money. That's not a boss move. I don't respect nobody who does crap like that. When people say, "Oh, I see these ads on like, Facebook and social media. Oh, I could teach you how to get your podcast popping." Like with anything, things take time. Things are not instant. But we live in a microwave society of wanting to get stuff done right. So I'm just like, what is wrong with these ladies? I mean, I know motherhood has changed Hazel a little bit, but watching her on that one reality show with couples, she's very controlling. And I don't know, like the way things were going, that was very ugly to me. And like, as Asiatic people, we have to try to get along, man. We have to move past stuff, certain stuff. Like, you don't always have to say stuff. Let me tell you this, you don't always have to say stuff. There is people right now that do not like me, that get mad at my content and what I post. They talk plenty of crap to me. I don't always say stuff. Sometimes, most of the time, I just look at it and laugh. Like, that shit's funny. And it's mostly people with no profile pictures, so you're too ugly to show your face. I'm just saying, let's be real. So that first conversation went nowhere. Thank you to my haters, and thank you to those that support me. Also, please subscribe to, or please listen to my podcast. It's on Spotify and Anchor. I will have the link in the description, and I will put the episode of the conversation in the description box. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. And remember, stop letting people get under your skin. Sometimes it's just best to be quiet and not say anything back. Peace and blessings.